Hello friends, welcome to this invigorating Vinyasa yoga floor for full body strength, mobility and flexibility. In today's practice, we will be flowing to the tempo of our breath to help us reconnect with our inner well-being and establish a beautiful and empowering tone for this day. Let's begin today's practice in child's pose, balasana. Take a moment to relax your arms. Soften your forehead onto the mat. Widen your knees to allow space for your belly and your rib cage. Offer yourself these first few moments of practice to check in. Notice if you're present, or perhaps the mind has already taken you on a journey. Might it be possible to let go of whatever was going on before this practice? Let go of any obligations you might have for afterwards? Give yourself permission to honor this space. Recognize this sanctuary that you have cultivated. From this space of loving awareness, begin to notice your breath. Notice the rise and fall of your belly and your rib cage. Notice where you can soften. Allow each breath to invite more space into the body, more space into this experience. Let us take two nourishing breaths together. Inhale through the nostrils. Exhale, let it all out. And again, inhale. Exhale, let it all go. As we flow throughout this vinyasa, I invite you to pay close attention to the breath. Allow it to be your guiding anchor. On your next inhalation, walk your hands in towards your torso, mindfully rise up, reach your arms overhead, and soften your arms down. Join your palms together behind your back. Join the thighs together. Inhale, open up the chest. Exhale, forward fold. Return your forehead to the earth, guide your arm bind overhead. Feel the beautiful opening across your chest and your shoulders. Inhale. And exhale. Offer yourself one more breath here. Continue to create space around the shoulders. Keep the arm bind. Find an inhalation here. And on your next exhalation, mindfully rise up, open up the chest. Inhale. Exhale, release the arms. Let's come into tabletop. Stacking shoulders atop of wrists, hips atop of knees. On your inhalation, arch your back, gaze forwards, cow pose. Exhale, round your spine, chin to chest, cat pose, marijasana, bithilasana. Creating gentle spinal waves as we begin to wake up the back body. If you're performing this practice first thing in the morning, you might notice a bit of tightness or stiffness around your upper back and your neck, and that's okay. Allow yourself to ease into this practice at your own tempo. Let's meet in tabletop. tent up onto your fingertips and step your right foot between your palms. If you like, you can shift your back knee slightly towards the back of your mat. Inhale to raise your arms skywards, low crescent moon. Offer yourself one breath here. Inhale. And exhale. Find an inhalation here. Exhale, stabilize the pelvis. Engage the core muscles, pivot to the right, spreading your arms out wide at shoulder height like bird wings, softening your shoulders down away from your ears. Inhale. On your exhalation, guide your right palm behind your left thigh. Raise your left arm skywards, shine your heart upwards. Inhale, raise both arms. Exhale, palms on the earth. From here, shift your hips back, straighten your front leg, half monkey. Square off the hips, lengthen your spine. Left palm on the earth, inhale. Raise your right arm, gaze up. Continue to flex your right foot. Guide your toes towards your shin. Return your right palm to the earth, re-bend your front knee, lift your back leg, straighten your front leg, pivot your back heel in. If you like, you can shift your foot forward slightly, coming into an expression of our pyramid pose. Pressing firmly into the right big toe mound and into the blade edge of your back foot. Continue to lift up through the arch of your foot. One breath here, inhale, and exhale. Let's transition into triangle pose. Right palm either on your shin, on your ankle, your hand towards the inner seam of your foot, maybe fingertips on the earth. Reaching your left arm skywards, opening up your chest, lengthening both sides of the waist. Inhale. On your exhalation, engage the core muscles, rise up. Glide your back arm down your left leg, raise your right arm, reverse triangle. Feel the opening for your side body. And from here, bend your front knee, maybe shift your back foot back slightly. Let's come into our warrior two, Virabhadrasana. Shoulders are stacked atop of hips. Reaching arms out in opposite directions. Inhale. Exhale, square off the hips, palms on the earth, step back to plank pose. Inhale in your plank pose, activate the core muscles. Exhale, bend the elbows, lower down, forelimb staff pose, chaturanga dandasana. Inhale, open up the chest, upward facing dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Offer yourself a moment to stretch out the back body. Lengthen your tailbone skywards. Breathe. Inhale, and on your exhalation, mindfully lower your knees down onto the mat, tent up onto your fingertips, this time left foot between the palms. Inhale, raise your arms skywards, Anjaneyasana. Notice the beautiful opening for your right hip, the expansion across your heart and your chest. Soften your face, reach your arms skywards, inhale, exhale, pivot to the left, perhaps gaze towards your back hand, either stay here, or on your next exhalation, place your left palm behind your right leg, raise your right arm skywards. Breathe. Notice where you feel sensation within the body. Notice where you can invite softness within the body. On your next inhalation, raise your left arm, gaze forwards. Exhale, fingertips on the earth, shift your hips back out of the Hanumanasana. Square off the hips, lengthen your waist and the back of your neck. Notice the deep stretch for your left leg. Right palm on the earth. Inhale, raise your left arm, gaze up. Return your left fingertips to the earth. Rebend your front knee, lift your back leg. Step your back foot in slightly, pivot your heel in, coming into pyramid pose. You can either keep the spine lengthened or find your forward fold. Continue to guide your left hip back and slightly shift your right hip forwards. Allow yourself to soften the upper body. Be easy as you notice the sensations along the back of your left leg. Offer yourself one breath here. Inhale. And exhale. You might like to again shift your back foot in slightly, perhaps pivot your heel in slightly further, and come into your expression of triangle Trikonasana. The intention here is to focus on lengthening both sides of the waist, keeping the chest open rather than finding depth. So if you've got your torso pretty upright, your hands somewhere along your thigh or around your knee, know that that's okay. Inhale. On your exhalation, engage the core muscles, lift the torso, glide your right arm down your right leg, raise your left arm, reverse triangle. Press into the left big toe mound. Gently rise up, bend your left knee, perhaps shift your back foot back slightly, coming into Warrior Two. Feeling the opposition in energies as you root your feet into Mother Earth and reach your limbs out in the sky. Inhale. And exhale. Find an inhalation here. On your exhalation, palms on the earth, square off the hips, step back to plank pose. Find your vinyasa, or if you like, you can head straight to downward facing dog. Offer yourself five mindful breaths in downward facing dog. If you prefer, know that you could lower the knees down and rest in either child's pose or perhaps puppy pose. Inhale, exhale, lower your knees onto the mat, point the toes, balasana, find softness. Walk your hands in towards your torso, mindfully rise up. Let's work our way onto our sits bones. Bending your knees, joining your heels together. Lifting your feet up off the mat. Grab a hold of the outer edges of your ankles. Inhale. On your exhalation, begin to extend your left leg skywards. Inhale to bend. Exhale to straighten your right leg. Inhale to lower. This time, lift both legs together. Inhale to bend. Let's do that again. Exhale, lift both legs. Inhale to bend. Exhale to lift your left leg. Inhale to lower. Exhale to lift your right leg. Inhale to lower. On your next exhalation, lift both legs. Inhale to lower. Exhale, lift both legs. Inhale to lower. On this next round, lift your limbs up. You can either grab a hold of your legs or raise your arms skywards. Engage the core muscles and the thighs. Point your toes, lengthen your legs. Breathe. And gently re-bend your knees. Soles of the feet on the earth. Place your fingertips behind your back. Exhale, lift your pelvis. Reverse tabletop. Ardha Purvottasana. Activate your glutes. Press into the big toe mounds. Continue to open your heart without puffing up the rib cage. Keep your knees aligned with your hips. One mindful breath here. Inhale, exhale, lower the pelvis down. Let's come into boat pose, Navasana. Option to grab a hold of your thighs or extend your arms out in front. You can keep your knees bent or straighten your legs. Continue to lengthen the spine or open up your chest. Relax your face. And gently release. Either coming into reverse tabletop or we'll find our reverse plank, Purvottanasana. This time legs are extended, press into your heels, inhale. Exhale, lift up, activate the posterior chain. Smile and breathe. And gently lower the hips down. Cross your legs, palms on the earth. Let's step back to downward facing dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Lengthen the spine, stretch the backs of your legs. You can stay here or let's find a vinyasa. Inhale to plank pose. Exhale, bend the elbows, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Exhale, Adho Mukha Svanasana. On your next inhalation, raise your left leg, three-legged dog. Exhale, left knee to left wrist. Let's set up for pigeon pose. Lower the pelvis down, point your back toes. You can either keep the torso elevated, or if it's in your practice, let's come into a forward fold. Perhaps resting your forearms or your forehead on the mat. Soften into your left glute. You can either stay in your forward fold or upright, or let's come into mermaid and king pigeon. So shift your left heel in slightly closer towards your right hip bone. From here, flex your right knee. You can either grab a hold of your foot or place your foot between your elbow crevice. Maybe raise your left arm skywards or open up the chest. If you like, you can interlace your fingers together or maybe find a mudra. Continue to stabilize the body here. Breathe. Lengthen your spine. If you'd like to take this further, return your left fingertips to the earth, grab a hold of the outer edge of your right foot, arch your back, guide the crown of your head towards your right foot. Maybe you raise your left arm skywards, or maybe you grab a hold of your right foot with both hands. Now, this can be a very advanced backbend for some of us. So honor where you're at today. If you're in this expression, continue to guide your navel to the spine so that we are protecting the lower back. Wherever you are in this stretch, let's return our fingertips to the earth and meet in downward facing dog. Perhaps offer yourself a moment here to stretch out your legs. And when you're ready, let's roll through and find a vinyasa. Exhale, Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale to raise your right leg. Exhale, Kapotasana. Take a moment to stabilize your pelvis, adjust the positioning of your legs, either staying upright or folding forwards. You can stay in your passive stretch, or let's come into our heart opener. Lifting the torso, guiding your right heel slightly closer towards your left hip, flexing your left knee, either placing your foot in your elbow crease or grabbing a hold of your foot or your leg, maybe raising your right arm, coming into your expression of mermaid pose. The intention here is to open the heart, to lengthen the spine, to stretch the hips and the shoulders, and to ensure that the lower belly is active so that this is a safe and empowering stretch. You can either stay in mermaid pose or we'll come into king pigeon. So releasing the bind, grabbing a hold of the outer edge of your left foot with your left hand, arching your back, guiding your head towards your foot. Maybe you keep your right fingertips on the earth, maybe you raise the arms skywards, or if it's in your practice, use both hands to find that connection. Lovingly release from this posture. Return your palms to the earth, tuck your back toes under, downward facing dog. Offer yourself a moment to pedal out the legs, stretch out the hips and your back. Option to stay in down dog, or let's find our flow. Inhale, Falakasana. Exhale, Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Exhale, Adho Mukha Svanasana. One breath here. When you're ready, soften your knees onto the mat, point the toes, Balasana, child's pose. Give yourself permission to surrender. When you're ready, walk your hands in towards your torso and gently rise up. Roll the shoulders back and down. And let's work our way into a cross-legged seated position. Lengthen your spine. On an inhalation, raise your arms, palms together. Exhale, easy twist to the left. Inhale through center. Exhale, spinal twist to the right. Lengthen your spine, soften your shoulders down away from your ears. Inhale through center. Exhale, palms towards your heart. Inhale to raise the arms, call upon empowering energy. Exhale, guide this energy in towards your heart center. And again, inhale to open up. Exhale, palms towards your heart. Close your eyes. Take a moment to thank yourself for showing up to this nourishing practice. Let us round off this yoga vinyasa with the mantra Om. Inhale to prepare. Om. Namaste. Sending you love and light. May you be well. If you enjoyed this practice, check out the suggested playlist in the description below, or check out one of the transformative online programs available. If you enjoyed this, you can also leave a comment down below, give this video a thumbs up, and subscribe to this channel.